let's have a look at how you can slice samples using the slicing mode of the simpler device. In the transient slice mode of the simpler device, the algorithm automatically detects the transients within the sample and creates corresponding slices, which are smaller parts of the actual sample in its entirety. Let's have a look at the drum loop that I've already loaded into this simpler device. The slices have been detected, and I can play these back using my MIDI keyboard. I can now play these slices in a completely different order from the original drum loop sample. I can adjust the sensitivity of the slice algorithm, and by reducing the sensitivity, I increase the size of the slices and reduce the number of slices that I have. I can change the playback mode of the slices from trigger to gate, meaning that the samples will only play as long as I press a key on my keyboard. And I can also adjust the fade in and fade out times. The playback mode is set to mono and allows me to play back each slice individually, but only one at a time. I can change this to play polyphonically. In other words, I can play more than one slice at the same time. And the last mode is the through mode, which allows me to play a slice, but then the playhead continues to play the rest of the sample until I play another slice. With the beat slicing algorithm in Simpler, I'm able to slice a sample in time divisions. My current beat division is 1 bar, and it has sliced my sample into 2 equal parts. I can change the time divisions and making them smaller or larger. Slicing using the region algorithm means that I can slice a sample according to the number of regions I'd like to have. This means I can choose any number that I feel fits the sample that I'd like to slice. The total number of regions that I can have is 64, but this doesn't have to be an even number, so I can choose whatever number fits the composition that I'd like to create. The manual slicing algorithm allows you to create your own slices where you see fit on the sample in Simpler. To do this, you can simply double-click in the sample display to create your own slices. If you hover over a slice, you can move the position accordingly, or you can simply double-click on the slice to delete it. So these are just some examples of how you can use the different slicing algorithms to slice your samples the way you would like to. Feel free to experiment with the different algorithms and see what you can come up with.